Good morning, one and all. I am Bhaskar, Assistant Professor of English at St. Martin's Engineering College. I have been working English, Assistant Professor of English for various colleges for more than 12 years. Today's my topic for discussion is prepositions. So we all of us aware of preposition. So prepositions are, we all of us know, but we think that preposition is very easy, but it is the toughest topic in English grammar. So we will see what are the rules and all, how to overcome those problems. So we will see one by one. So let us have the look at prepositions. So what is the definition of preposition? We will see. So definition, rules, what are the changes which will occur? So we will see one by one. Sir, see the definition of preposition. A preposition is a word or group of words used to prepare a noun or pronoun. So we all of us know what is noun, what is pronoun. Noun is the name of person or thing. So what is pronoun? In the place of noun, we use the pronoun. So before the pronoun or noun, we used a preposition. Preposition is or noun or noun phrase. We all of us know noun phrase also. So it shows the direction or type or place or location. So this preposition shows these type of directions. Direction or type or place or location. These will help us to move. So where we have to insert the preposition, it will show with proper guidance. So preposition is more important in grammar topic. So these are special relationships or to introduce an object or some examples of prepositions or just like in, and, on, of, unto, and so on. There are many types of prepositions. So we will see these are just examples of preposition. So we know preposition is a word or group of words we use before a noun or pronoun or noun phrase. So that is the main intention of preposition. So we have to see meaning of preposition. We all of us know just we say preposition. That is very linear we think. But here there is a meaning of preposition. Preposition, the name of preposition, pre plus position. Pre means before. Position, what is its position? That is a preposition. If you change one meaning, if you change the preposition, it will change entire meaning. So that means we have to be careful of using any preposition. Means, place or before. A preposition typically comes before another word. So it is comes before the another word. It should not, for example, if you take only one word, it's not a preposition. It should have noun or pronoun before it. That means it has some meaning of that word. Noun, phrase or noun. It tells us about the relationship between the noun, phrase and another part of the sentence. So Webster term prepositions are in, of, on, or with, or at. There are many words. So we will have glance at all these by some examples. See, these are the some of the words, some of the prepositions. See, few examples are given. The book is on the round table. The year, if you remove this on, there is no proper meaning. If you remove on, there is no proper meaning. The book is around the table. If you remove on, there is no proper meaning. If we add on is a preposition here. The book is on the table. Around it shows relationship of space. Space, where it is located. Space. The book is on the table. And second example we will see. We will meet in November. Here preposition is keep. When we will meet? We will meet in November. It is month of the year. November. In November. Relationship is time. It is showing time. Here it is space. Here it is time. And last one is the relationship of method. I send the information by email. Why is a preposition? Why is one kind of preposition? It is showing method. Which way we are following? Method is why. I will send information by email. Not by telephonic or not anything else. By email. That means letter format. So this is a some kind of preposition examples. Prepositions in English are highly idiomatic. So they are just like idioms. Idioms we cannot understand directly. They are inner meaning. So how to overcome these? By reading all prepositions we can overcome all problems. Although there are some rules for usage. All prepositions are not in same. So we have some rules. So we should follow those rules to overcome any problem. So how to use it? We will see. Much prepositions uses dictated by fixed expressions. See the example. In this case, it is best to memorize the phrase instead of the individual prepositions. If you see example, we will understand. All prepositions are not just in or enter, not like that. There are some phrases, we have to follow those phrases by giving full sentence of the meaning. So that is the reason. So rules for prepositions. Prepositions are direction. Direction it is going, it's showing, this some kind of prepositions are showing direction, which direction it is going on. To refer to a direction, use the prepositions to, in, into, on, and onto. So these are, if you use these prepositions in a sentence or in a word, we should feel that it is giving direction. She drove to the store. Here, to is preposition. Where she is going? Going to the store. Drove means she went out. She drove to the store. Don't ring the doorbell. Come ring in. Into, you are in or into. This is preposition here. So don't come and ring. Just come into the room. That meaning is here. So here, into is preposition. It is also showing direction. Drive on to the grass and park the car there. Drive on, driving on. Here, these are combined prepositions. There are some other rules. Just I am showing only individual prepositions, giving directions. Drive on the grass and park the car there. So here preposition is on or to. We can use both combined or even one also correct one. So these are some kind of direction of prepositions. Okay, next one, preposition of time. We have seen preposition of direction. The second one is preposition of time. It refers to the one point in the time. Use the preposition in, at, and on. This shows time. In, at, and on. These are some kind of prepositions of time. See the example. Use in with parts of speech, they are not specific types. Before months, in months, or years, and seasons. See the example here. The weather is cold in December. We have to use in before months, in December, in November, in January. Just like yes, in 2021, in 2020 like. And seasons, in winter season, in summer season, in rainy season, like this we have to use. The weather is in cold in December. In is a preposition. It shows season. She was born in 1996. She was born in year, it shows the year. All these are showing time, the preposition of time. In is 1996. This is year, this is month. Yeah, same continuous preposition of time. Same. And we have seen in, on, and yet. This is last part one. Use yet with the time of day. Also use yet with noon, night, and midnight. We have seen. We have to use in for in December, in January, in February like. Whereas yet is used during night time, during at night, during with noon, at afternoon, or at 8 o'clock, or at midnight. We have to say like that. See the example. I go to work at 8 o'clock, at 8. It is showing the time of at work. I go to work at 8 o'clock. He eats lunch at noon, whether it is afternoon or any noon. Noon. It's at lunch at noon. It is showing these are at text or showing over time only. Okay, next one. For work at night. I go to work for night. This is also showing night at night. This is also showing time. And last one is they go to bed at midnight. This is also showing at midnight. So this is also called time of preposition. So all these are important. And we have all these for having time, seasons, time and all these. Okay, next one is continuation. Use on with days, on. For example, I work on Saturdays, I work on Sunday, I work on every day. I work on any weekdays we have to use on. He does laundry on Wednesdays only. He does laundry on Wednesdays only. Remaining days he will not work. He does only laundry on Wednesday. So on is mentioned here, on, before big days we have to use on, before years we have to use in. See, these are the primary prepositions of time. See, when to use yet, when to use in, when to use on. See the examples, you can understand easily. Yet is used for precise time, particular time. Yet is used only for particular time. For example, at 10:30 a.m., yet, there is no extra time, before or after. extra time. There is at 10:30 we are, at 8 o'clock, at particular time. There is no any preceding or succeeding. A particular time we have to use it only at bedtime, at breakfast time. That is used precisely, it's very particular and comes correct time. Hindi is used for months, years, decades, centuries and long periods of time. For example, in 16 years time, there is no specific, which 16 we don't know, but we have to say 16 years. In 1991, it is in December. So Hindi is used for before the years, decades, centuries or any period of times. There is no particular. But whereas yet is used only particular thing, that is at 8 o'clock, at bedtime, at breakfast. Whereas coming on, unused for any, for days and dates. For example, on summer evening, on Christmas Day, on Christmas, on Friday. So all these are before days and dates, Whereas in is before years, decades, months and whereas at is used particular time. If there are examples at 10:30 a.m., at 8 o'clock, at breakfast, at bedtime. So only at is particular time, whereas in is before centuries, years and months, whereas on is before days or any seasons, on Christmas Day or summer day. In this way you have to use. So these are very primary, but we should not get any confused. Why? Because in any competitive exam, they will ask this type of confusing prepositions. So we should aware of all these things. Yeah. Next one is preposition of place. Yeah, this is also important. Preposition of place. We have seen preposition of direction, preposition of time, and third one is preposition of place. To refer to a place, use the prepositions in. We have used in preposition of time also, but here we are using as in, just as place of in. For example, the point itself, particular point, if it is any particular point, we have to use in only. Yet as a general density, on the surface and inside something contained. See, for example, if you see examples, we can understand easily. Yeah, people use time, there are examples here. They will meet in the lunch room. Say, here you. Place, where we will meet? In lunch room. They will meet in the lunch room. Only in lunch room we will meet, not any other room. She was waiting at the corner. This is preposition. Preposition of place. He left his phone on the bed. On the bed is preposition. She left his phone on the bed. Place the pen inside the dryer. Inside is preposition. Preposition of place. This one shows place and this one also showing place here. All are showing place. But whereas in the previous one, preposition of another one, here it is showing in front of months, in front of years, in front of decades. But whereas this particular place, whereas this one is any days of anything. Just like on Sundays and weekdays like this. See, this, by seeing this picture, we can understand very easily. See the first one. Behind, see the box. Behind the box, there is a ball here. So, by seeing the ball, where it is? Behind means we know. We know the meaning of behind. Behind, here in front of. See, this is a box. All shapes are same. So, you have to look at the ball. Then we can understand where the ball is located. In front of. Next two. Which we may confuse here. It is also we may think in front of, but here in front means this one, this area. Here next to, here before, here above, this back to, behind, this side. So these are some confusing prepositions we may get confused. Here see, there are two boxes between two boxes, one ball is there, between. And next one is near, they are not close. We may get confused from here and here. From here to here. Here just near, not close. Here next to, just touching. Next to. Here last one below the box. Ball is below the box. Here inside the box. Here on the box. You may get confused in both two also. Above means there is something between ball and box. But here there is no gap. Here there is something is gapping here. So you should aware of these things. Okay, next one, preposition of locations. location. To refer to a location, use the prepositions in an area or volume, at a point or on a surface. They live in the country. They live in the country, the area. It shows the area. She will find him at the library. This is point of time. Where she is finding, where she is there, or he is there. There is a lot of dirt on the window. This is surface. See, location. Location means here. Dirt on the dirt window. On window there is some dirt. Here we can find him on at library. Here in the country, they live in the country. So he is showing the location, where it is located. We can say where the things are located. That is more important. Okay, types of preposition. There are many types. So we will see one by one slowly. There are five different types of prepositions. So far we have seen just sample prepositions. But here we will go through little different ones. Simple prepositions, double prepositions, compound prepositions, participle prepositions and phrase prepositions. So we will see one by one to get clear understanding. What is simple preposition? Yeah, simple prepositions. Simple prepositions are words like yet, for, in, of, on, over, and under. So all these are simple prepositions. These common prepositions can be used to describe a location, time, or place. Already we have discussed about these prepositions. It will show location, or time, or place. We show simple prepositions, just like already seen. Yet, in, on, for, before, all these are simple prepositions. Next one is, see the examples for simple prepositions. He sat on the chair. One is showing there where he is sitting. Sat on the chair. There is some milk in the fridge. In is preposition. There is some milk. All these are simple prepositions. Simple means only one preposition. There is no combination of any words. She was hiding under the table. Under his preposition. The cat jumped off the counter. Off his preposition. All are simple prepositions. He drove over the bridge. Over his preposition. She lost her ring at the beach. Empty preposition. And the book belonged to actually. Yeah, to his preposition. They were sitting by the tree. By, to, at, over, off, under, in, on. All these are simple prepositions. So there is no much difficult of having simple prepositions. Where I coming to the next prepositions, there are some problems of, see, this is also simple preposition. How it is having, definition of simple preposition is, the simple preposition is just short words that are used to define a relation between nouns or pronouns or even connected to parts of speeches, clauses or sentences. All these are simple prepositions. Examples of simple prepositions, already I have discussed this. Yet, by, as, but, from, in, into, then, up, on, out, over, but. All these are simple prepositions. So no need to read all these. Next, second one is double prepositions. Double prepositions. So what is double preposition? Two prepositions come together. See, when you see what are they, one by one. A double preposition is a word that is made by the combination of two simple prepositions. Yeah, see. Two simple prepositions are coming as a one preposition. That is double preposition. See the examples. In, into. In is different and to is different. But you are adding as a one preposition, just like into and onto. Inside. In is different, side is different. But here we are adding only as a one preposition, just like into. And upon, up to, outside, out of, without, within, from behind, because of, according to, from beneath, next to, etc. So these are double prepositions. Double preposition is nothing but adding two simple prepositions as a one preposition as double. Into, just like. See the examples. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful prince. The baby climbed onto. Yeah, here upon is double preposition. Up plus on. Here on plus to. Onto. Here it is up to us. Up to us to find the answer. Up is different, to is different. The loud voice came from within the stadium. Within. With is different and in is different. Within the stadium. And next one, she never leaves without her phone. without, with is different, out is different. So this is double preposition. First one is the caterpillar turned into a butterfly. In is different and to is different, but making as a one preposition is into. That is double preposition. See the some preposition examples. Just compound preposition. We have seen simple preposition and compound preposition. Double preposition. The third one is compound preposition. So what is it? A compound preposition consists of a combination of words that is often considered as one preposition and connects the object of a preposition to another word or set of words. See the example. According to, actually these are not prepositions, but they made it as compound preposition. According to, in regard to, apart from, by means of, in spite, in place of, along with, instead of, in front of, ahead of, in spite of, because of. So all these are compound prepositions. We have seen, so far we have covered prepositions of how many types are there, what are they, and these are very important for everyone's life. So better have this aware of prepositions so that we can improve our language skills. Thank you.